My name is Eric Plutz. I am the university organist at Princeton University and am seated at the University Chapel organ built by E.M. Skinner and renovated by the N.P. Mander Company of London, England. I've been here for 15 years, but prior to this appointment, I was the music director at Church of the Epiphany in Washington, D.C. Thank you to the current music director, Jinsun Cho, for graciously inviting me to perform on the Tuesday concert series. Due to travel restrictions, I was not able to make this recording at Epiphany, but I am able to share this instrument with you. It excels at playing English romantic music, so I've prepared a program of smaller works by English composers, except for that first piece. The American composer Calvin Hampton wrote his Fanfare for the New Year to be performed at the Cathedral of St. John the Divine in New York City, highlighting the famous state trumpet more than a football field away from the main organ. It was performed at the stroke of midnight to welcome the New Year, so it seemed appropriate to play it today. Next up is a lovely introspective work called Folk Tune by Percy Whitlock. Surrounded by Whitlock's beautiful harmonies, the tune is not an actual folk tune, while it does exemplify one. This concert is going to be broadcast on January 5th, still within the 12 days of the Christmas season. Therefore, I thought I could play Herbert Sumsion's grand setting of Adeste Fidelis, better known as O Come All Ye Faithful. Towards the end, you will hear the tuba mirabilis of this organ. Tuba mirabilis is Latin for remarkable trumpet. This set of pipes is under the highest wind pressure of the whole organ and sound especially remarkable in the tenor register, which you will hear. English by birth, Healey Willan later immigrated to Canada, where he spent the majority of his life. The title of this work is Epithalamium, which means a poem or song written or performed in celebration of a wedding. This was composed by Willan and played at the wedding of the daughter of friends of his, but not prepared for publication at that time. It has since been published and gives us a glimpse into the improvisational style of Dr. Willan.
Thank you.
William Mathias was a Welsh composer whose music is instantly recognizable as his tonal language remained constant throughout his life. Always rhythmically driven, his Toccata Giocosa is emblematic of his compositional style. William H. Harris was professor of organ and harmony at the Royal College of Music from 1921 to 1955. In addition, he was organist choirmaster at St. George's Chapel, Windsor Castle, from 1933 until 1961. Due to this unique appointment, he was one of the composers chosen to write music for the coronation of King George VI in 1937, and for the coronation of Queen Elizabeth II in 1953. While he is most often remembered for his Anglican choral music, his Flourish for an Occasion for organ is a rare gem. Well structured and full of variety, it gives a sense of grandeur commensurate with St. George's Chapel and perhaps royal occasions. Henry Walford Davies was William Harris's predecessor at St. George's Chapel, Windsor Castle, beginning his work there in 1927. Following the death of Sir Edward Elgar in 1934, he was appointed Master of the King's Music until his death in 1941. Solemn Melody was originally written for organ and strings. This is an arrangement for solo organ, a hallmark of which is a seamless crescendo and diminuendo. Blind from birth, Alfred Hollins did not let his condition restrict his work. He successfully pursued an international career as organist, pianist, and composer. While he was a student, music was becoming available in Braille, and he memorized major organ works, including all of the fugues by Johann Sebastian Bach. His triumphal march showcases both of the high-pressure trumpet stops on this organ, just as the opening Fanfare for the New Year did. The first one is the Tuba Mirabilis above my head, here at the console. The second, which appears just moments later, is the gallery trumpet, over 200 feet away at the other end of the building. Thank you for listening. I hope you've enjoyed this concert. I also hope you are able to continue supporting the Tuesday concert series at the Church of the Epiphany, a spot that will always have a special place in my heart.